asking you, how long is your attention span? Is it 5 minutes, 8 minutes, or over 10 minutes? Okay, raise your hands. 5 minutes. 8 minutes. Over 10 minutes. Oh my God, that means I have to speak for over 10 minutes because you guys are listening. No, no, no. It's really short. And because I want you to grasp everything that I said. And I'm really happy to be talking to you today because if you've seen my social media, I've just finished a course at Harvard Business School. And then I've come back. And I have so much knowledge that I want to share with you right now. Anyways, so you are all entrepreneurs here, right? You all want to be entrepreneurs here, right? Okay, so first things first is you've heard thousands of people telling you to think outside the box. You've heard that before, right? Think outside the box. But the first thing is you need to know what is in the box before you can think what's outside the box. So only if you know the base and the core of what's in the box, then you can think out of the box. So when people tell you to think out of the box, it means first look back at the box and then think out of the box. Next is that how many of you are on social media? Everybody. Amazing. So social media, my social media account has been managed by me predominantly, but by different social media managers. But I want to tell you that why I need a social media manager is because I get different perspectives from them. Not because, you know, they create amazing content for me, but I like spending time with them. So I had this company that was handling me before called First Show. Now they make movies and all that stuff. And the perspective that I got from them was phenomenal. I mean, they told me, I'm in my early 30s, and they told me to think like a person in their 20s. For me, in my early 30s, my friends are thinking about fertility and babies, but you guys are young. You're thinking about what? You're thinking about acne, beauty, peer pressure, bullying, all that. I've passed that stage. So for me to think back like you people, I had to become one of you, which is amazing. So what I'm trying to tell you, what I'm trying to get at in business terms is that you need to use data to create products and influence people. Today, my social media account tells me what I need to create, what a product I need to create, and how I can solve for a purpose. Another thing is I was on my way to your college and then I heard the radio. So how many of you listen to the radio while you commute? So statistics show that a lot of people that are under the age of 35 listen to the radio because you guys commute a lot. Even corporate India is under the age of 35. A large portion of corporate India is under the age of 35. But then suddenly, because of Women's Day, people started advertising mammograms. You know what mammograms are, right? Mammograms are tests for breast cancer. But if you're under 35, you don't need a mammogram. I don't qualify for a mammogram. You need an ultrasound. So, you know, just by letting these people know, it's marketing to a different audience. So you need to use data to create products. And this tool is there for you people. It wasn't there as easily available as it was a few years ago, but now it's easily accessible. Next, what I want to talk to you about is, okay, so my grandfather, how many of you know my grandfather, Dr. Reddy? So my grandfather, Dr. Pratap C. Reddy, was the founding chairman of Apollo Hospitals. And he did this when he was in his 50s, 60s. He had a very, very strong practice and he was minting money in the US. He used to live in Chicago, in Boston, in that area. And he used to work at Mass General, Massachusetts Hospital. And then after that, his father sent him a letter and his father lives in Aragonda. And he said, listen, you must come back and serve your nation. So he left everything. He has four daughters. And then he said, okay, he's coming back to serve the country. Forget all that. It's amazing. He created Apollo Hospital, 74 hospitals, a few institutions, blah, 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 blah. But what's amazing about the man is he's 86 years old. You won't find this on Google. But he's 86 years old and he still goes to office every day. By 10 o'clock, he's in office in his chair. Why I say 10 o'clock is because from 9 to 10, he's doing puja in the temple. And I'm like, what's wrong? Tata, that's why, you know, every morning if I'm not up, I feel guilty. In my early 30s, I'm feeling so guilty that this 86-year-old man is able to, go to the office. So this is what discipline is. And if you see, all the most successful people are disciplined. So discipline is a key factor in your success. So what I want you to do is, it doesn't have to be one person. So you have to put in qualities of different person and create an imagery of that person. And that person will automatically become you. Please try that, okay, this weekend. If you can try and make an imagery about yourself, about who you want to be, that's your first step towards, reaching your goal. So, you know, you need to like prioritize time to actually do that. So if you create an imagery of who you want to be, make sure you have all these elements of who you want to be in it, okay? So four activities to reach your goal and scale your business. First is roles. Okay, be clear on your roles. Know your reports. Follow a routine. And then follow rituals. There are some rituals that you can never break. Like my grandfather goes to the puja room every single day, morning and evening. And he's done that for I don't know how many years. Then another thing is, you've heard, so many of you guys are like, you know, thinking, oh, how many of you think exams are a burden and pressure? Now see? I'll tell you what exams and things are. So it is about analyzing your priorities and your non-negotiables. So in corporate terms, I would call it burnout, but in your thing, I would call it, if you think exams are a burden, then that means you do not know proper time management. Because they should be easy. And you should be grasping the right things. Exams are supposed to be fun. You get to go home early, don't you? And after exams come holidays. Isn't that amazing? Yeah, so exams change the way you look at exams itself. And then it'll be a much better atmosphere for you to approach it. It won't become a stress anymore. So the thing is, put your priorities. Have some non-negotiables. So you know your goal. Do any of you have goals? So I know you guys are in a very nice college. So coming, being a class topper is priority for you, right? Or just passing? Is it just passing or getting a high grade? Just pass. Okay, anyway, whatever it is, it's your goal. So to get to your goal, you need to prioritize the non-negotiables. The non-negotiables are, I will wake up every morning, for example, you don't have to do this, but when I wake up every morning, I will spend 2 hours studying. Okay, now I'm sounding like a preacher. I never did it, but I'm just telling you, this is a non-negotiable. So I used to, my study time was between 3 to 5. Which was my least productive time because I would have eaten a huge lunch and I would feel so lethargic. But see, then I changed that and then, you know, I was never a fabulous student, so that's fine. But coming back to it, know your priorities, find your goals. So I listen to a podcast every day. That's my non-negotiable. Whatever happens under the sun, I listen to a podcast. My husband's non-negotiable is, anything could be happening around the world, he will work out. And he will ask me, have you worked out? And I always put a crying face saying, no. You know, so these are the non-negotiables that you have to figure out in your life. Then, how many of you know how to climb a ladder? Okay, amazing. So if you have to climb a ladder, you know that you have to go through small steps, right? If you go right on top, you'll fall. So I heard this on a podcast with Jay Shetty. I listened to him. I happened to listen to him while working out. And if you reach the top, you won't be able to balance. You won't be able to balance. You'll just crash down. So they are stepping stones to reach the top of the ladder. I mean, you have to go through all the steps. So in your goals also, prioritize what is the most important for you to achieve. and how you're going to go step by step. If I want to become the president of India, what do I have to do? I need to like figure out my goals now so then I can be the president of India at a considerable age. All of you know the meaning of a postmortem? What's the meaning of a postmortem? Come, come, please stand and tell me now.
Dividing your body parts accordingly.
For what? To find the cause of the death. Okay, that's the postmortem. So it happens after you've died, right? Okay, so my mom told me in business, you know, people keep doing postmortems. After a product has failed, they'll be like, oh, why did this go wrong? But she said, you know what's rocking nowadays and helped our organization? I said, yeah, please go ahead and tell me. She said a pre-mortem. A pre-mortem happens before you launch a product or a service. So you do a pre-mortem to see what is the worst thing that can ever happen. And are we ready to brace it if it's the worst thing? You've put your whole money in it. Are you ready to be broke and stay in the thing, stay on the streets? That's a call you need to take. And then plan accordingly. But are you future proof? Because when you're creating a product, when you as a human being at this age are putting your blood, sweat and everything into it, is your business future proof? My grandfather at 60, today is 86, so he's about, I don't know, like 30 years ago? Yeah, around 30 years ago, he built Apollo Hospitals. Is Apollo Hospitals future proof? The question is, we don't know what the future is moving to. But we know that small things will keep changing day after day. Maybe you don't need to come to the hospital for OPDs anymore to consult a doctor. Okay, next question. How many of you use Swiggy? Ah, amazing. Swiggy, movies, I'm getting to know so much about you. But anyways, so Nandan Reddy. Okay, he came to speak to us some time ago. And I thought that was the most insightful talk I've been to in so long. The guy is also in his early 30s, 29 or 30 or something like that. And he told me, and when he was talking, he said, you know what I want from Swiggy? I said, I was looking at him saying, what? He said, I want share of throat. So what? Do you guys know the meaning of share of throat? Okay, so let me explain to you. Share of throat means how many times a day do people eat? 3, average, right? So that's how many meals in a month? 90 meals in a month. Out of that, and all the food is going through your throat, yeah, he wants a certain percentage of that. That means right now, out of the 90 meals you're eating a month, he wants, his purpose is to make Swiggy serve you for those, for a certain percentage of those meals. So what will happen if he gets share of throat? What will happen? Think about it. You know what will happen? You can spend more time with your mom rather than her spending time cooking in the kitchen. Cooking won't become a burden anymore. It'll become amazing for the women of the house. It'll give her time to do what she wants. It'll free up her time. So, future-proofing your business. So these are points that you need. First is discovery, strategy, structure, system, adoption, improvement, customer service, and people culture. As I said, solve for a purpose. So like Swiggy, solve for a purpose. Your business needs to solve for a purpose. So losing customer obsession. So unless you're obsessed about knowing what your customer wants, you will never have business insights and your business will fall apart. Same way, if your principal doesn't know what his students want, his institution may not be as successful as it is right now. So because your principal knows how what your needs and requirements are to grow and to maximize your potential, you are in such a reputed institution. I want to end by saying, light has no meaning if there's no darkness. So you won't understand the importance of light if there's no darkness. So life is going to show you all these things. Get ready to face fear and rejection. I get trolled left, right, and center, but I've become thick-skinned now. I'm not going to take it personally. I'll try and improve, but I'm not going to let it affect me. So in the world, you have to be up for rejection. And you need to brace the world. Life is going to give you tons of opportunities. It's up to you to grab it and make the best of it. Thank you. Thank you.